for all the graduates, the Metropolitan Peace Academy, for Vanessa's energy. For Vanessa's energy. So, it's great to see so many people tonight. You guys are lovely. And in light of Dr. King's 91st birthday yesterday, and the history of street outreach work in Chicago, the work that you all do, I want to focus my remarks this evening on legacy. The definition of legacy is a gift of property, especially personal property, as money, by will, a bequest, anything handed down from the past, as from an ancestor or predecessor. So I think about what is my legacy, and I'm hoping you're thinking about what is your legacy. I think about what I want my legacy to be, and I'm hoping that you think about what do you want your legacy to be. Often when we think of legacy, we think of things, items, material possessions, but your legacy isn't always about things. Usually it's about who you are and how you touch people's lives. Referring to Dr. King, the impact that he had on others when he was alive and still has to this day is astounding and extremely inspiring. When I reflect on the field of street outreach in Chicago and the strides we've made to change how everyone views the staff, the participants, their families, and communities, we are leaving a legacy that will force people to acknowledge this work as a legitimate and professional field, as they were doctors, lawyers, engineers, and scientists. All of these professions, including street outreach, require education, training, support, and a consistent opportunity for the fields to grow, refine, and last. The medical field, for example, is well respected and is often given the benefit of the doubt that they have good intentions and ultimately help people. Although there are examples of doctors that are guilty of malpractice and are a detriment to the medical field, they still get the benefit of the doubt. We still go to doctors. A few bad apples do not taint the entire field. The same courtesy must be given to street outreach. Street outreach is a field that also helps individuals, families, and communities, but because it has not previously been viewed as legitimate, our work has to be highly focused now on making it more effective, professionalizing it, and sustaining it. Street outreach needs to be a mainstay and without starts and stops. This will be the legacy. I want to make reference to CSFIRE. CSFIRE has a legacy. Many of you in this room come out of the CSFIRE school. I see you guys. So we have to start a new legacy and continue this legacy. Legacy also means we have to allow room for younger generations to learn and contribute to this work. The last few summers, we've had incredible flip workers, and many of them have been young, vibrant minds who are equally as passionate. We must continue to embrace them. I have a question for you all. Where do you think it's best to plant a young tree? In an open spot in a forest or in a wide open field? Okay. Ecologists tell us that a young tree grows better when it's planted in an area with older trees. The reason, it seems, is that the roots of the young tree are able to follow the pathways created by the former trees and implant themselves more deeply. Over time, the roots of many trees actually graft themselves to one another, creating an intricate interdependent foundation hidden under the ground. In this way, stronger trees share resources with weaker ones, so the whole forest becomes healthier. That's legacy. An interconnection across time with the need for those who have come before us and a responsibility to those who come after us. The idea of legacy may remind us of death, but it's not about death. Being reminded of death is actually a good thing, because death informs life. It gives you a perspective on what's important. But legacy is really about life and living. It helps us decide the kind of life we want to live and the kind of world we want to live in. For both young and old, the power of legacy enables us to live fully in the present. You understand that you are a part of a larger community, a community that must remember its history to build its future. There is caring combined with conscience. There is also wisdom to be found in each other, linking action and reflection to deal with complex problems. Legacy is very much about life and living. People say that when you think about leaving a legacy, you feel a lot happier and purposeful. The more I thought about the topic, the more I understood that while leaving a legacy is important, it is not as important as living your legacy. I would like people to talk about me in the way I want to be known when I'm alive. I think this is more exciting than thinking of what people will say when I'm no longer here. So for the graduates, I wrote you a poem. You want to hear it? Here it goes. Legacy, legacy. What will it be? One of leadership or of struggle and then achieving? One in remembrance of constantly giving or just always receiving? One that will last less than a week or more than a decade? It may be quickly forgotten, or maybe it will never fade. Whatever it will be, make it be in the now, shining in the now, growing in the now. Whatever it will be, make it be in the now. I'm encouraging all of us to live our legacy. After all, living your legacy will ensure you leave a lasting legacy. Thank you.